I'm not ashamed.
Why did God meet and seek to kill Moses? This is the question that we seek to answer today as we continue our verse-by-verse study of the book of Exodus on walking through the Bible.
Verse of his word, the glory of his cross.
If you have a Bible with you, you can turn to Exodus chapter 4. We're going to be reading from verses 24 to 31. If you don't have a Bible, don't worry. Just follow along with us on the screen. The version that we'll be reading from is the New King James Version. So, Exodus chapter 4, beginning at verse 24. And it came to pass on the way at the encampment that the Lord met him and sought to kill him. Then Zipporah took a sharp stone and cut off the foreskin of her son and cast it at Moses' feet and said, "Surely you are a husband of blood to me." So he let him go. Then she said, "You are a husband of blood because of the circumcision." And the Lord said to Aaron, "Go into the wilderness to meet Moses." So he went and met him on the mountain of God and kissed him. So Moses told Aaron all the words of the Lord who had sent him and all the signs which he had commanded him. Then Moses and Aaron went and gathered together all the elders of the children of Israel. And Aaron spoke all the words which the Lord had spoken to Moses. Then he did the signs in the sight of the people. So the people believed, and when they heard that the Lord had visited the children of Israel and that he had looked on their affliction, then they bowed their heads and worshipped. In verse 20, we have Moses setting out for Egypt. He was sent by God to Egypt in order to secure their release from bondage. Moses was traveling with his wife Zipporah and his two sons, Gershom, and as of yet an unnamed son. Along the way, a peculiar story happens that is often not discussed because of the topic under consideration. It is, however, important, for it shows us the importance of following the words of the Lord. Along their trip, they came to an encampment, or a place of rest, and there the Lord met Moses and sought to kill him. We don't know how the Lord did this, so it's useless to speculate. But even so, why did the Lord do this, seeing as how he had just ordered Moses to go to Egypt in order to set the people free? Verse 25 gives us the answer. Moses failed to circumcise one of his sons. Circumcision was a sign of the covenant between God and Abraham, and it was an everlasting covenant that would be performed by every subsequent generation. In Genesis 17:9-14, we read, "And God said to Abraham, 'As for you, you shall keep my covenant, you and your descendants after you throughout their generations. This is my covenant which you shall keep between me and you and your descendants after you. Every male child among you shall be circumcised, and you shall be circumcised in the flesh of your foreskins, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and you. He who is 8 days old among you shall be circumcised, every male child in your generations, he who is born in your house or is bought with your money from any foreigner who is not your descendant. He who is born in your house and he who is bought with your money must be circumcised, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. And the uncircumcised male child who is not circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin, that person shall be cut off from his people. He has broken my covenant." Circumcision was not an option for the Israelite. It was a command, which if not followed would mean that the person was to be cut off from his people. The child, though, in this story, as a child, could not be held responsible for breaking this command, for he could not circumcise himself. So the father would be held responsible, in this case, Moses. Since verse 20 says that Moses had sons, plural, which we know to be two from other passages, and since Zipporah only circumcised one son, it can be inferred that Moses' oldest son had been circumcised, but his youngest son had not. Why had his second son not been circumcised? Because Zipporah didn't like the act, for she viewed it as bloody. However, Zipporah was not going to let Moses die, so she took a sharp stone and circumcised her son and threw his foreskin at the feet of Moses, saying that surely you are a husband of blood to me. What did she mean by this? That she had secured Moses' life through the shedding of her son's blood. Even though we're not told directly in this story, from Exodus 18:2-3, we find that after this incident, Zipporah and the children did not continue with Moses to Egypt, but returned to Jethro. In verse 27, we find that the Lord appeared to Aaron, saying for him to meet Moses in the wilderness. Aaron obeyed the command of the Lord and met Moses at the mountain of the Lord, Mount Horeb. There Moses told Aaron all the words of the Lord, as well as the signs that he was to perform among the people. The question is, when did the Lord appear to Aaron, and when did Aaron meet Moses? From simply reading the story itself, it appears that Aaron met Moses during Moses' journey to Egypt. However, from earlier on in the chapter, in verse 14, God told Moses that Aaron was already coming to see him. That means that verse 27 precedes verse 20, and that Moses and Aaron traveled to Egypt together, even though he is not mentioned in verse 20. We see this type of storytelling done in Matthew 26 as it concerns the story of the woman who anointed Jesus. Verses 20 to 26 detail a story only involving Moses, Zipporah, and their children, so Aaron is not mentioned. However, verses 28 to 31 involve a story of Moses and Aaron, so it would need to be said that Moses actually met Aaron. They met at Mount Horeb in Midian, after which they went to Egypt. When Moses and Aaron arrived, they gathered together all the elders of the people of Israel, and Aaron spoke all the words the Lord revealed to him through Moses and did all the signs the Lord had told Moses to perform. The people believed the signs just as God said they would and were thankful that the Lord had looked upon their affliction and would deliver them. So they bowed their heads and worshiped. With that, our time is up today. Lord willing, we hope you'll join us for tomorrow's discussion of Exodus chapter 5, verses 1 to 9, as we continue our walk through the Bible. Wonders at a time.
I'm not a
Thank you for watching today's episode. We hope that you found it edifying and ask that you not only subscribe to our channel and podcast, but that you like and share this episode among your friends so that the saving gospel of Jesus Christ can go out to the whole world.
Of his cross.